Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate a new capability in version 12 to create a JUnit test for a message flow node using recorded messages in the flow exerciser. After creating the test case, I will run the test case and show the results in the JUnit view. I will also show how using the message assembly editor, you can extract the path to an element and test for a specific value in your test case. Now, in a previous video, I demonstrated how to create a test case for a message flow node by selecting the node and then selecting create test case, which launches a wizard, which allows you to create a test case. And in the previous video, I selected an input file and an output file. And the preview here on the right hand side changes as you alter the options on the left hand side. There is an even easier way to create a test case using recorded messages from the flow exerciser. So what I'm going to do is put the flow into record mode. And I'm going to send a message to the flow. And I can now see that the flow is in record mode. It's recorded the messages of a message that's been put into the flow, and the path that the message has taken is shown by the blue line. Now what I can do is select the node that I want to test. So I'm going to select the compute node here, and I'm going to right click and select create test case. And what that will do is show the same wizard as before, but it has detected that I elected to create the test case while in the blue line record mode. So the wizard is using the input message assembly just prior to the compute node as the input message, and it is using the output message assembly as the expected message assembly to compare against the actual message assembly that is propagated. So the code is shown in the preview here, and all I need to do is click finish. And the test case is shown in a Java editor. And the test case is created in a test project, and the message assemblies are shown in a resources folder underneath the test project. I can run the test project, and I can see that the test passes. So that's a very easy and quick way to create the test case from the flow exerciser. So let's have a look at the internals of the code that was generated. So the test case is using the same classes as before, so spy object reference, node spy, and test message assembly. Spy object reference is an object that is used for creating mocks at test time. It references the application, message flow, and node, and it's using chainable methods to reference the artifacts using Fluent API. The node spy is a class which allows you to observe the node behavior at test time. And the test message assembly is an object that represents the message assembly. So these are all instantiated at the top of the test case. And I have used a method here called build from recorded message assembly. So the wizard has generated this test case, and it's using this method here on the input message assembly object to create the input message assemblies, is building it up from the recorded message that was saved. After the input message assembly is formed, it is sent to the input terminal of the compute node using this evaluate method on the node spy. And a couple of asserts are made using hamquest matches. So an assert is made that the node is invoked once, so using the node call count is matcher there, and it is asserting that the message is propagated to the out terminal, and that is asserted using the terminal propagate count is matcher. The wizard generates a section of code to compare the actual message assembly with the expected message assembly. So two more objects are created, one for the actual message assembly and another for the expected message assembly. The actual message assembly is formed by calling the propagate message assembly method on the node spy object, and the expected message assembly is created using build from recorded message assembly. It's the same way as the input one was created, so building from the output message assembly that was saved in the resources view. So I can also have a look at each of these input and output messages. So the expected and output and actual message assemblies are compared using this equals message matcher, and if they're equal, that assert will pass. I can view the input and output message assemblies by double clicking on them. So the input one is using, so they both use the message assembly editor. The input message comes in with a message using the XML and the C domain here, and the output message assembly is in JSON here. So what I can do is change some things in the message assemblies just to show that the test is using them, and we can cause a failure and show what happens when assertion fails. So if I change the output message assembly so that the element here, greeting, if I change that to a different element name like hello greeting, for example, and save that, if I now rerun the test again, this time I see that it fails, and if I look at the stack, I can see it says it expected actual greeting, but it was different to the expected name of hello greeting. If I revert this back to how it was before and save that and rerun, the test passes. So another thing I can do is to check the value of a specific element in the message body. So in the compute node, there is code in here which is reading a file name from the input local environment tree and assigning it to this element here called file name. So what I can do is in the output message assembly, I can select this element here, file name, and I can select this option, right click on it and select this option, copy eSQL path. I select that, and now if I go to my test case, I can add some code here to check that the value is the expected value. So if I do something like string actual value equals, now I can look up the element from the message assembly. So I can select actual message assembly and then select the method message path, and now I can paste the path that was copied, and after that I can select the method get value as string. So that has retrieved the actual value. I can create another value variable here called expected value and set it to my, so it should be expecting my demo.json. So I'll put my demo.json here. And now I can use an assert equals expected value, actual value, and just add the import and save that. So that is using this assert, comparing an expected value and an actual value. So if I also, before running the test, if I cause the test to fail by changing the input message assembly, so that where it's reading that file from, if I change it to something else like wrong my demo.json and save that. So now if I run this test now, we'll see it's failing. And if I look at the message, it says expected my demo.json, but was wrong my demo.json. Okay, so if I go back to the input message assembly and correct what's in the local environment tree, values assigned to the object in the tree, the message body. So now if I run it now, I can see that it passes. So in this video, I've shown how to create a test case very quickly for a node in a message flow while in the flow exerciser, and when the recorded path is shown in the editor. The generated test case uses the recorded message assemblies that are captured while in record mode. I've described the internal workings of the test case and shown the matches that are used in the test as well. Finally, I showed how to compare a specific element in the message body with an expected value.